Hi everyone, and welcome to part two of our three-part series, Investing and Tax Planning Strategies. Today I'm going to discuss phase two, the wealth achievement phase, the time in your life where you're approaching retirement and have accumulated enough assets to begin what we call is your second act. Before discussing these two strategies, I strongly suggest that you create a cash flow projection. First, determine what your income is going to be from various sources such as Social Security, pension. Estimate what your expenses will be both now and through retirement, and therefore you can determine how much money you're going to need to withdraw from your investment portfolio each year. Once you know how much you're going to withdraw from your investment portfolio, the first strategy is determining which accounts to withdraw from and in what order. Let me explain. You have three different types of accounts. Your taxable accounts, accounts that you've already paid taxes on when you've invested them, although there may be some capital gains embedded in them. Your qualified accounts, your IRA or 401k accounts, accounts that you will have to pay taxes on when you withdraw money from them. And a Roth account, an account that you've paid taxes on, so when you withdraw money, it will be tax-free for you. Most people withdraw or take money out of their taxable accounts first. They let their qualified accounts continue to grow tax deferred. And then at age 72, there's a required minimum distribution that you need to take out. But is that always the best strategy? You really want to see what tax bracket you're going to be in, because at age 72, you may be in a much higher tax bracket than you are when you first start to withdraw money down. We recently looked at a client at age 65. The couple was 65 years old, and their withdrawal strategy had them in a 5% effective tax bracket. But at age 72, the tax bracket was going to jump to 35%. So for them, the strategy of spending down their taxable account first and then withdrawing from their qualified accounts later on was not the best way to go. I do want to emphasize three things. Make sure that you have as close as you can accurate numbers for your income and your expenses. You do the tax projection or have somebody do the tax projection so that calculated properly. And finally, take the time value of money into consideration. Proper analysis will determine the best withdrawal strategy from your taxable, qualified, and Roth accounts. Strategy number two. Roth conversion. This is one of my favorite strategies to use. Let's discuss what it is and why it's so powerful. A Roth conversion is we take money out of your traditional IRA and you put it into a Roth IRA. Now you have to pay taxes at the time of this conversion, so why would you do so? Well, if you're going to be in a lower tax bracket now and a higher tax bracket later on, it may make sense. Also, the money that grows in a Roth is not only going to grow tax-free, but when you withdraw the money, it should be tax-free to you as well. And third, there are no required minimum distributions from a Roth IRA. Now, we use special tax analysis program to determine how much and how much savings that you're going to be over your lifetime. And a lot of times it's hundreds of thousands of dollars over someone's lifetime that you're going to save on taxes. Now, there are a couple of caveats to be aware of. One, when you convert money to a Roth, you do have to wait 5 years before you can withdraw money tax-free. Exception is if you're older than 59 and a half. And two, if you withdraw money before you're 59 and a half, you do have to pay a 10% penalty on any earnings that you have, not the principal. I do want to point out that there are some times before your age 72 and after that you have stopped working, we kind of call it the donut years, where you could be in a really low tax bracket and the Roth conversions really make sense. But even if you're still in the wealth accumulation phase, Roth conversion may make sense if you have a year where you have a lot of tax losses or you have very little income. I hope these strategies are ones that you feel beneficial. If you'd like to speak to me or any of our advisors, please contact us at hellowealthmanagement.com. Thank you, and stay tuned for part three, wealth distribution phase.